This first song that we play, it's going to be called La Fiesta del Mariachi. It's a perfect starter for this evening. And we have a special surprise for everybody today. We have a very special guest that we're going to introduce here in a second. So I hope you enjoy this one, La Fiesta del Mariachi.
La fiesta va a comenzar, adornen esos bordones, la fiesta va a comenzar, adornen esos bordones.
Ya va llegando el mariachi cantando soles con sus guitarras y guitarrones, va que se alegren y que retocen los corazones. Ya va llegando el mariachi cantando soles con sus guitarras y guitarrones, va que se alegren y que retocen los corazones. Ay, la, 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 la. Ay, la, 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 agarre su falda pa' que se baile este lindo son. Ay, la, 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 saque polvadera pa' que retoce mi corazón. La fiesta sigue bonita, toda llena de alegría. La fiesta sigue bonita, toda llena de alegría.
Sigue tocando el mariachi con sus violines, con sus trompetas y la vihuela, pa' que se alegre y se contenta mi linda nena.
Sigue tocando el mariachi con sus violines, con sus trompetas y la vihuela, pa' que se alegre y se contenta mi linda nena.
Ay, la, 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 la. Ay, la, 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 la,
agarre su falda pa' que se baile este lindo son.
Ay, la, 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 ay, la, 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 la,
sé que polvadera pa' que retoce mi corazón.
Es la fiesta del mariachi, la que alegra el corazón.
Caciques, mariachi los caciques. Okay, we're gonna have something very special now, and I'm gonna give you a little brief history of what we're about to do, which is very, very new. I don't think it's been done before, but this is very exciting for us. And again, this is something that has stemmed from the creativity of Mario, and he telling me, hey, what about this? And me not saying, well, you know, I don't think that can be done, but us working together and saying, let's do it, let's make it happen somehow. And so we're gonna do something very different. I'm going to talk a little bit about the male ballet dancing. One of the most distinguished male dancers in history was Francis King Louis XIV. Ballet in the 17th century was a formal and stately affair and very different from what you see on the stage today. Through his love of dancing, Louis supported the founding of the first Academy of Dance in 1661. The Academy trained the first professional male dancers. At the time, men were the dancers, since their athletic bodies were ideally suited to the strenuous activity of dancing. Dance has been an integral part of society connected to religion, war, hunting, agriculture, births, weddings, and deaths. The folk dances of any nation reflect a people's culture integrated within the community and its customs. From folk dancing, ballroom dancing, and ballet derive their roots. Michael Sherrod is a 12th grade student at Lakeview High School. He has choreographed two original ballet pieces to traditional Mexican songs and is accompanied by the Lakeview Mariachi students. He will be attending TCU University School for Classical and Contemporary Dance, majoring in modern dance. Michael is proof positive that music unites us, thus reminding us of our human commonality. Ladies and gentlemen, can I introduce to you now, Mr. Michael Sherrod is going to be dancing to La Llorona. One more round of applause, Mr. Michael Sherrod, ladies and gentlemen. The first time we rehearsed with Michael, it was at Lakeview, and we weren't able to get the auditorium at that time because another group was rehearsing. So he actually rehearsed just on the regular in the cafeteria on the floor. And I got to be honest, after we first saw him, we all gave him an ovation because we didn't know what to expect. And once we saw him dance, we were amazed. I mean, he's phenomenal. He's a phenomenal dancer, and we're very excited that he's gonna be working with us today. He's gonna be doing another song here in a little bit. But again, we know La Llorona as a dance that we get to see, and of course, for us that grow up in a Mexican home, you hear La Llorona, and sometimes they use it to make you go to sleep for some strange reason. Go to sleep, but te agarra la llorona or something. And, you know, that's the way our culture perceives it. But as we can see, the music is beautiful. And, of course, with Michael dancing to it, it even makes it even more beautiful. So we're going to move on. This next song, we're going to take you all the way to the state of Veracruz. And we're going to feature several songs from this. This is called Viva Veracruz. And it's going to feature several singers. We're going to feature Monica Escandón on the violin. We're going to feature Fernando Aguirre on the guitar, also singing. Belen Hernandez on the trumpet singing, and also Mr. Alvaro Ramos. This is called Viva Veracruz.
Pasó volando una calandria María, una calandria María. Por aquí pasó volando,
por aquí pasó volando una calandria María, una calandria María. Por aquí pasó volando
y en su piquito llevaba una rosa de Castilla, que el viento la deshojaba como blanca maravilla.
Y en su piquito llevaba una rosa de Castilla, que el viento la deshojaba.
María Chuchena se fue a bañar a orilla del río, muy juntito al mar. María Chuchena se estaba bañando y el techador la estaba mirando y le decía:
María, María,
ni techo tu casa, ni techo la mía, ni techo tu casa, ni techo la mía, ni techo la casa de María García.
Burrito que traigo, lo traigo de Sete Pango, lo traigo de Sete Pango, es burrito que traigo, y lo vengo manteniendo con cascaritas de mango. Ese burrito que traigo, lo traigo de Sete Pango, lázalo,
lázalo,
lázalo que se te va, échame tus brazos, mi ama, si me tienes voluntad, lázalo,
lázalo,
lázalo que se te fue, échame tus brazos, mi ama, y nunca te olvidaré. Échale.
No es pinto ni es colorado, no es pinto ni es colorado, este torito que traigo es un torito barroso de las llaves está cerrado. Este torito que traigo lo traigo desde Alverado. Lázalo,
lázalo,
lázalo que se te va, écheme tus brazos mi alma, si me tienes voluntad. Lázalo,
lázalo,
lázalo que se te fue, écheme tus brazos mi alma y nunca te olvidaré.
Estaba María Chuchena sentadita en la barranca, sentadita en la barranca. Estaba María Chuchena.
Estaba María Chuchena sentadita en la barranca, sentadita en la barranca. Estaba María Chuchena
con su vestido en las piernas, recogiendo flores blancas. Estaba María Chuchena sentadita en la barranca.
María
Raya Chuchena se fue a bañar a orilla del río juntito al mar. Raya Chuchena se estaba bañando y el techador le estaba mirando y le decía:
María, María,
ni techo tu casa, ni techo la mía, ni techo tu casa, ni techo la mía, ni techo la casa de María Chuchena.
Ay, ay.
That was called Viva Veracruz, and it featured several songs from the state of Veracruz. This next song that we have, these next two songs, we're gonna put two songs together. We took to the UIL state competition this year, which we've been to for the third time in a row, and we're very excited. I'm very proud of the students. Every year, I was talking to the students not too long ago about our first year that we went to the UIL state competition. And we had about three violins up there. We had two trumpets, and we had a whole lot of guitars. Because everybody likes to play the guitar. But it was our first year, and the kids remember that, and we were like, man, we were not very good. And I said, well, you got to start somewhere. And luckily, you know, we've grown ever since then. Our program right now, as it stands, has about, combined Lincoln and Lakeview, we have about 160 students in our program. And it, yes, yes. And it's, I tell the students, it's all testament to their work and to them playing so well and working so hard that the students that are coming up in the elementaries, they see them and they're like, we want to be like them. I tell them, they want to be like you guys. And so they set the standards really high. And next year, I'm expecting another 70 to 80 students coming up. So I'm going to be hitting over the 200 mark. And we're very excited. You know, the kids are loving the music. And, you know, I'm very excited to offer that to anybody who wants to. Just because the music of mariachi, it's so beautiful, so lively. So, on this next song, we're going to feature Miss Alani Jimenez. She's going to be singing a beautiful song written by Mr. Juan Gabriel. It's called No Discutamos. And after that, we're going to go right into another canción veracruzana called El Balajú. We hope you enjoy these two pieces.
No discutamos, porque después de la primera discusión hay muchas más. Hoy terminamos. No discutamos. Tuve la culpa, fue mi error por no decirte francamente que ya no te amo. Ya te pedí perdón y no me quieres perdonar. ¿Qué quieres que yo haga? Que me quede o que me vaya, porque no puedes evitar que yo lo quiera. Es más, lo amo. No me preguntes que cuando comenzó este amor, porque por Dios, que no me acuerdo. Tan solo sé que lo encontré y de que él me enamoré y hoy lo quiero, es más lo extraño. No discutamos, tuve la culpa, fue mi error por no decirte francamente que ya no te amo. Que yo lo quiera, es más, lo amo. No me preguntes que cuando comenzó este amor, porque por Dios, que no me acuerdo. Tan solo sé que lo encontré y de que él me enamoré y hoy lo quiero, es más, lo extraño. No discutamos. fue mi error por no decirte francamente que ya no te amo.
No me quiso llevar, Balaú se fue a la guerra.
Le dijo a su compañera, vámonos a navegar, a ver si llegaba al otro lado del mar.
Ariles y más ariles, ariles de la cañada, la mujer es la que pierde, el hombre no pierde nada.
Ariles y más ariles, ariles de
querido, le dedico esta canción, le dedico esta canción a mi México querido.
Cuando fuerte lo grito con todo mi corazón, hay que tener todo bien como México ganó.
Ariles y más ariles, ariles sigo cantando, hasta ahorita mi región, a la que yo quiero tanto.
Ariles y más ariles, ariles después que me
No discutamos en el Barajú. One more round of applause for all the singers, ladies and gentlemen, please. The next song that we're going to perform, we're going to slow it down. I know we've been going high energy. We're going to slow it down a little bit for you today. And this is a very, very special song that we want to give to, we want to dedicate to a very, very special someone in the audience today. I'm going to read these notes that we have here, and this is, we want to thank this special person. Tonight's program is dedicated to Ms. Patsy Eckert, who is the embodiment of the humanistic credo, i.e., your friends are not those whom you've known the longest, but rather those individuals who step into your life when least expected and announce, I'm here for you. Con mucho cariño, de Mario Castillo y el Mariachi Los Caciques. This song is dedicated to Ms. Patsy Eckert, Tú Solo Tú.
Mira cómo ando, mi amor, por tu querer. Borracha y apasionada, no más por tu amor. Mira cómo ando, mi bien, muy dada la borrachera y a la perdición. Tú, solo tú, has llenado de luto mi vida, abriendo una herida en mi corazón. de mi desencanto y desesperación. Solo tu sombra fatal, sombra del mar, me sigue por donde quiera con obstinación. Y por quererte olvidar, me tiro a la borrachera y a la perdición. Tú, solo tú, has llenado de luto mi vida, abriendo una herida en mi corazón. De mi desencanto y desesperación.
That's great.
Ladies and gentlemen, can we give it one more round of applause to Miss Clarissa Rodriguez? And of course, Miss Patsy Eckert for all the generous, she's been very generous to the mariachi. Thank you so much for all your support, Miss Patsy Eckert. And before we go on to the next song, Clarissa Rodriguez is my very first senior, a mariachi student that is graduating this year. And I'm very, very proud of her. I'm very proud of the support the parents have been giving us this program this entire time she's been here. So let's give one more round of applause to Clarissa Rodriguez, and we wish her the best in her college career. Okay. This next piece that we're going to play for you, we're going to bring Michael out here in a little bit, but I want to tell you a little bit. This next song that we're going to play is called La Bruja, and I know you, my man, Mr. Ramos must really like Halloween or something, I was actually in Washington, D.C. with two of my students last year, and thanks to Mario and the internship that we had, and we were in his kitchen, and we were with some other students, and Mario was just, like I told you before, very relentless, always pitching ideas. Hey, what about this? What about that? And then I said, man, there's a really nice song called La Bruja, and it's really creepy, and it's beautiful. The traditional ballet folklorico dance behind it is beautiful. And he said, you know what? Let's do ballet to it. And I was like, I had no idea. I was like, well, let's go for it. I was a little hesitant at first, but then I know Mario. And I was like, well, we'll make it happen somehow. I know that he's gonna make it come to life. And this is how this song with Mr. Michael Sherrard came to life. This is called La Bruja, and it's gonna feature Mr. Michael Sherrard, ladies and gentlemen.
Tú es volar, ay mamá,
para venir.
al cuartel, me vuelve maceta, me da de comer, me agarra la bruja, me lleva a su casa, me vuelve maceta y me da calabaza.
Dígame, dígame, dígame usted, ¿cuántas criaturitas se ha chupado usted? Ninguna, 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 lo sé, ando en pretensiones de chuparme usted.
Me vuelve maceta, me da de comer, me agarra la bruja, me lleva a su casa, me vuelve maceta y me da calabaza.
Dígame, dígame, dígame usted, ¿cuántas criaturitas se ha chupado usted? Ninguna, 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 lo sé, ando en pretensiones de chuparme usted.
Mr. Michael Sherrod, ladies and gentlemen, one more round of applause, please. Great job, Michael. Great job. That was Miss Belen Hernandez singing La Bruja. Can we give her one round of applause, please? Belen Hernandez, beautiful voice. And I know I didn't get to mention this earlier, but La Llorona was sung by Miss Deja Gomez. Deja, can you please raise your hand? Can we give her a round of applause? She did a great job on La Llorona as well. I'm very proud of her. The next song that we're going to perform for you, we're going to take you back to the early 1900s in Mexico. And we all know that during those times, especially the 1910s and the 20s, we had the Mexican Revolution happening in Mexico. And a lot of stories are told about Adelitas and people that helped everything happen. You know, all the aid that was given to the people organizing the revolution. This next song is called Las Coronelas, and it's based off of the revolution. We hope you enjoy. This is called Las Coronelas.
Thank you.
That was Coronelas. Before we do our final song, I would like to recognize, if I have any students from the Lincoln Middle School program, can you please stand up? Any students from Lincoln or Lakeview, please stand up. We got some back here. Awesome. This is the future of our program. Awesome, I see. I would like to call up three students who, some of the leaders in our programs here. I'm gonna have them come up here, that way you guys can see the future of this program. We have Taylor McLaurin, if you're up here, can you come up here? I don't know if Darren Anthony is here. Darren Anthony. Dakota Sevier, come on up. Mr. Willie Rodriguez. And I want Mario to come up here with the students so he can get a good look at them. Come on up here, guys. And one of the things, yes, let's give him a round of applause. Just come on up here. One of the things that Mario and I have always talked about, and the power of music in general, where I say, well, you know, maybe some of these students don't know how to speak Spanish, but we understand that the music goes beyond just words. It's about emotions. It's about what you feel. And I tell the students, it's okay if you don't know the words, you're gonna learn them. And a great example is one of my students, Miss Taylor McLaurin. She wanted to sing the song Cariño, and Mr. Ramos, like, I'm having trouble pronouncing the words, and I said, well, just keep working on it, you'll get it. And sure enough, you know, whenever she auditioned, she made, and she was in the front singing whenever we had our spring concert. But it shows that any student can do it. Just music is so powerful that it transcends any kind of language barriers. And mariachi music in general is that powerful as well, that anybody can play it. And I want you guys to understand that's what we do here is, I open the door for anybody. You don't have to just be a Spanish speaker, but anybody who wants to play music can be a part of this program. And I'm gonna let Mario say something about that. Thank you.
Good evening. Thank you for being here with us tonight. This is a great adventure. And just forgive me a minute while I have a private conversation with Patsy. Patsy, todo esto empezó en la busca de un sombrero. ¿Te acuerdas? Y del sombrero hemos llegado a esto. And what I just said to Patsy, this all started with my hunting for a hat or many hats. And all of you made it happen. And I am so very, very pleased that you're here. I appreciate your support. But it's important that you see these faces because my next project, and Jan, you're going to have to get up earlier than you do now, because a 6 a.m. response to my emails from 2 o'clock in the morning is unacceptable. But there is a private boys' school in Washington, D.C., not far from where I live. It's called St. Albans. It's probably one of the most prestigious and oldest private schools in the United States. The who's who's of the world send their children there. And so I thought, why shouldn't San Angelo send the future who's who's there? So my next project, my next project is to start with two young boys, and I'm going to search for scholarships from St. Albans. I met with the headmaster's wife and some of the professors, and they've promised to help me make it happen. So hopefully next year, one or two of you will be there. And once I finish with the boys, I'm gonna move on to the private girls' school. And I'm not gonna take no for an answer, so you'll get ready.
We've come to our final song, and thank you so much for being patient with us and for being here supporting the Lakeview Mariachi and the Lincoln Mariachi. Our final song is a very, very powerful song, and it takes a very, very powerful voice to make it happen. One of the most powerful voices that we've ever seen here at the Lakeview Mariachi, and extremely talented young man, and we're very, very proud of all the leaps and strides that he's made throughout the years. Singing the beautiful Schubert masterpiece, Ave Maria, here is Álvaro Ramos. Álvaro Ramos, Ave María. Muchas gracias. Thank you, thank you. Gracias, gracias. Les vamos a tocar una más. We're going to play one more for you just so you go. But before we do that, we want you to take your seat. Mario has a very special present and scholarship for the students that have sung today. I'm going to go ahead and let him come on up, present that to you for the students today, and take care of that. Go ahead.
Wow. I can hardly believe what I saw here this evening. Was that not the most incredibly beautiful thing? Don't try to call me. I used up my entire battery taking pictures. And while I was doing it, I was panning across, and all of a sudden, the American flag popped up. And here's what I thought. What an incredible country we live in that encompasses all the great cultures of the world. The culture of Mexico and Mexican Americans is astonishing. And it's also our culture, American culture. And you know, I didn't grow up here. I tell people I grew up on the border, and they're real excited, and then I explain it's the Canadian border. But I'm here. And this wonderful heritage that's so much a part of ours. Aren't we blessed to live in San Angelo, Texas? Give ourselves a hand. Hey. And Rosendo, I mean, that guy works so hard behind the scenes that God bless him. Hey, Rosendo. Now, one more final introduction of a guy who's never behind the scenes. He's busy running the Art Museum, San Angelo City Council, the school district, and when he's not doing that, he's running Washington, D.C. and the American government. But he also has a job, I think, and he is the senior managing director of the Aegis Group in Washington, D.C., but he never forgot his home. Welcome back, Mario Castillo.
I get the fun part. So I'd like to have Alvaro come forward. Belen. Deja. And Michael. In 2017, I got a phone call from Rosendo Ramos, who said, "We need sombreros." My response to him was, "We'll go to Hobby Lobby." And he says, "Sir, that's not the kind of sombrero we want." And I said, "Well, what kind of sombrero do you want?" And he goes, "We want the authentic sombrero, and it has to have this, that, and the other." And I kept seeing the figures go up and up and up. And I said, "Rosendo, just cut to the chase. Give me price per unit." And he says, "About $350 to $400 a hat." And I thought, holy cow. I said, "How about five sombreros and they can pass it back and forth?" And he goes, "No, that isn't gonna work." And I said, "Well, okay, I'll see what I can do." So I put together a list of my friends, and some that became friends, and some that now wish they weren't my friends. And I called, I emailed, I wrote, I begged, I kicked, and I got the money. But here's the surprising thing. Money came in from sources that I had not reached out to, but had heard about this program. Money came in from the San Angelo Standard Times through the Scripps Howard Foundation. My neighbors in Washington, D.C., who have absolutely no connection to mariachi music, send in a very large donation. Patsy Eckert, La Grande de las Grandes came through. Elaine Bridges came through. Others came through. The mayor came through. Dell, Raymond, Oscar, Ted Weatherford, the Beasleys, the Mayberries. All of you came through when I called you. You took a giant leap into something I was trying to get you to do. Poppers, let me see your sombrero. I call him Mr. Poppers, and I'll explain why, Brenda. This is what I had to hustle for. They're beautiful, and thank you very, very much. Without all of you, starting with the parents, none of this would be happening tonight. I want you to know that. I may not get a chance to see many of you again, so tonight I thank you from the bottom of my heart. I'm an old school teacher, and I love kids. And you validated that love through your generosity. So, Alvaro, and the reason I call him Mr. Poppers, Brenda, is because he's particularly fond of the poppers at your restaurant. Now, Mr. Poppers, you are not to take this scholarship money and blow it at Miss Hattie's. Okay? One of the great pleasures of not having children is that you get to borrow them. It's kind of like the Lend-Lease program. Most recently, somebody named Jeff Curry foisted a new one on me, Taylor Velarde. I don't know how it happened, but now Taylor Velarde is part of my life. So I hope it's okay. And that's what happened with Belen. Ven acá. I was able to, for a day, act as parent on behalf of her family. I actually went to Amherst and was able to host her and her little friends for dinner. I never knew little girls could eat so much. They're expensive. Anyway, Belen, the future is yours. You're off to a good start. Please use this money wisely. Deja. Deja is an exemplary leader in the Lakeview Mariachi. You're a student, you're the president of the Mariachi group, right? She has a terrific voice. She's shared some of her plans with me. I'm proud of her, as I'm sure her parents are proud of her. And Deja, this is for you. And you're the one person I know is not going to spend it, so that's great. Now, I think there's a special place in a very warm place for crazy people, and I'm probably going to be there very soon. But anyway, I had a crazy idea that we wanted to do something different and that we wanted to sort of invigorate the program. And as Rosendo told you, he was in my home drinking coffee at a late hour. It must have been 6:30 in the morning. And he says, "Sir, what can we do to sort of freshen things up?" And he was playing songs, and I heard La Bruja, and I had not heard it in a long time. And I said, "What we're going to do, we're going to do something dramatically different. Think about this. We're going to do ballet." And he thought it was going to be, you know, Patsy, the ones with the traditional dress and from Veracruz. And I said, "No, no, 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 we're going to do ballet." And he's very polite. Rosendo is extremely polite. And he says, "Well, if you think so, sir." And I said, "No, it's going to happen." And so my next chore was to find a ballet dancer. And I was so lucky to find a wonderful young man who has the courage, the drive, the creativity to practice his craft. and to share that craft with his colleagues. Early this afternoon, I went backstage and I interviewed, I think it was Deja, and I said, is Michael any good? And she said, as did several of them, oh, he's very good, he's really very good. And I said, well, you know, he doesn't understand Spanish. And Deja said, it doesn't matter. He dances to emotion. He's very, very good. So. So we're going to make you an honorary mariachi. And as Rosendo has told you, or Howard told you, he's been accepted at TCU, and Michael and his mother, and I had the pleasure of having dinner with him when I first made it off a plane, finally. And I was impressed by his intelligence, his drive, and his dedication to his art. He's going to go to TCU. He's got some partial scholarships. So, Michael, this check is for $1,000 to be used against your school expenses. Congratulations.
Can we give one more round of applause to Mr. Mario Castillo for everything that he's done for the program? And we want to say goodbye today with one of the most popular mariachi songs that have ever been written. This is a mariachi anthem. We hope you enjoy. This is called El Son de la Negra. Vamos, muchachos. Échale. Gracias. Mariachi Los Caciques from Lakeview High School. Thank you. Have a great evening. Before you leave, I would like to also recognize my very good friend here, Mr. Ezra Ramirez. Come on out. Ezra Ramirez is a volunteer in public school, and he spends a lot of time out here with the students. And also all the parents that have helped me this year. It has been one of the best mariachi years I've ever had. Thank you, Liz Ramos, Angie, and Amanda, Ms. Ramos, Ms. Alvarez, everybody, that all the parents. Thank you. Oh, yes, ma'am.
Nada más tengo una cosa de decir, porque no puedo decir más que ustedes han enseñado a nosotros que Dios les bendiga.
Gracias. Thank you, Ms. Patsy Eckert. Thank you so much, San Angelo. Have a great night. Thank you so much for coming out tonight.